They're currently at 4-volt switches. They only need two more. All right? They only need two more. So I'll definitely have to catch two more. I can only fit two air slashes. So what I'm going to do? Two air slashes. Wait. Two turns. Switch to 10 growth. Catch a move. And that's the play that won me the game. What is up, everyone? Today we're showcasing a team you might be familiar with if you saw my previous video. It's my NoXL Ultra League Remix team, which brought me to expert rank in Pokemon Go Battle League. This was my favorite team to run so far, and I had so many amazing battles with it. So I thought it deserved two videos instead of the regular one per team I do. Man, there's some real good battles in this one. So stay tuned. For the ones not familiar with this squad, it's Tangrowth with Vine Whip, Power Whip and Rock Slide, Typhlosion with Shadow Claw. That's important because with Shadow Claw, it is quite a good safe swap. I had a lot of questions about why not Incinerate? Isn't Incinerate better? And well, there are definitely scenarios where Incinerate is better, especially versus like Grass types or Ice types, like a lot of Ninetales, you could just farm them down. Also versus Galarian Stunfisk, having Incinerate is quite nice. But if you have it in a safe swap position, having Shadow Claw is really nice. Because they're never going to switch something in that's like actually weak to fire. Well, you'll see the odd Stunfisk switch in. But once you have an energy advantage with Shadow Claw, that is still fine. Like, Incinerate won't really help you much there with the energy advantage you'll be gaining. But they usually switch in like a Jellicent, a Politoed, a Drifblim, I see as well. And then Shadow Claw is just really, really nice. And then in the back, we have Crobat, which I am running as a Shadow, but you can run it as like a regular form as well. Will be just fine. Having the extra bulk does definitely help sometime. If you have the option between both, though, definitely go Shadow, because I do prefer the tiny bit of extra damage. Now, we are in a tough spot. We had to give up switch advantage here, and now I have Crobat versus Galarian Stunfisk. Crobat is pretty slow to the moves. It's 7 air slashes for the first Shadow Ball. So I'm actually going to have to bait this Stunfisk right here with a triple resisted Poison Fang, which they shield, which is really, really nice. And now I might be able to get to the Shadow Ball. It will still be close. So I have two shields, but they also already have two Rock Slides stored up. So this is not great. Yes, another Rock Slide coming through. Can we hit the Shadow Ball on this Stunfisk before they hit another one? We do. Talk about hitting something, by the way. I would really appreciate it if you would hit that like and the subscribe, because it really does help out the channel out. All right, bye-bye. Stunfisk, Crobat. Definitely a Stunfisk answer. All right, Mandibuzz. I got a lot of questions about Mandibuzz lead. What do you do? What I always do, I farm to 7 Vine Whips. I throw the Rock Slide. And then I'll dip into Typhlosion to hopefully catch a move. Usually you don't catch, but sometimes they'll throw a Dark Pulse or Foul Play just to chip down a Typhlosion. Which is fine. They come in Jellicent right here. And this is again where having Shadow Claw is really nice. I go straight for the beam right here. Honestly, most Jellicent shield. Like 90% of a Jellicent shield. So probably better just to go for Blast Burn. Because then you might get to another Solar Beam right here. Or I have to throw soon. But I like going straight beam. Because honestly, you either get a shield or you get swift. So that's fine with me. But you could definitely consider going Blast Burn as well. I missed the Blast Burn there. I should have undertapped my Blast Burn and hit it on the jelly. And then I would be able to farm this down. Now I'm going to have to throw energy. So that's a misplay on my part. I would have had two Rock Slides right here to throw the Mandibuzz, which would have been quite nice. Again, the Mandibuzz does have some energy, but they don't throw it immediately. So go for the Rock Slide. They shouldn't be able to CMP type with me here, because Vine Whip is 2 turns, Snarl's 3 turns. But here's what happens. This is a desync CMP tie. It should not happen, but you know, it's fine. Sometimes it does. I'll just keep Crobat with 2 shields right there. And now I actually really have to hope it's not a Galarian Stunfisk in the back. And if it's not, I have a shot. And it's not. It's a Nidoqueen. And Crobat is okay versus Nidoqueen. But this is, again, another scenario where I'm going to have to bait with a double-resisted Poison Fang in order to be able to kill this thing. Because Crobat just doesn't get that quickly to the Shadow Balls. Because, like, well, Air Slash gives 9 energy per move, if I'm not mistaken, and Shadow Ball is 55 energy, so that should be 7 air slashes for the first Shadow Ball, which is quite a lot of, there's 21 turns, that's like way more than it takes Nidoqueen to get to 2 Poison Fangs. Well, 2 Poison Fangs is 22, so, but they do definitely outpace you. Alright, now go for the Poison Fang right here, on the Mandibuzz, and it's bye-bye. Alright, that's how you deal with Mandibuzz lead. Alright, Stunfisk lead. This is good. This is where you want to see Tangrowth, to be honest. This is, a good matchup, though it is a very close matchup. You know, Stunfisk is busted. There's nothing that needs to be said. like 3 rock slides will put me into the red, but luckily it only takes 2 power whips to knock out the Stunfisk plus some vine whips. But if I like catch a move here or a switch out with some energy and they're able to gain a bit of energy advantage later, Stunfisk is definitely still a big problem for this squad, but with teamwork you can always make it happen. I go for another whip right here. I think this knocks out the Stunfisk if they don't shield. Or maybe I need a couple more vine whips. Oh, I definitely need a couple more vine whips. They got off another rock slide right here, which will again put me into the red. So not an amazing counter, Tangrowth, but at least I end up with a move right here, which I will throw. This is a Deoxys coming in. I think I saw a counter come through. Yes. All right, we will just come in with the Typhlosion. This is not an amazing answer, but Shadow Claws at least add up. Did I already tell you why the name is on top, by the way? Yeah, these battles were all done on my Twitch live stream on Go Battle Day, and I had like guests over in the stream all day, so we had 2 screens in the same stream. So that's why the name is there, just to make sure people know which screen is mine and which screen is for my guests. So we're stuck with that, but hopefully it's not too much of a problem. All right, we'll go for another Blast Run right here. Before they get to another Psycho Boost, they no shield, it makes sense, and they bring in the worst thing I can see, a Galvantula, which is just terrible for Crobat. It's terrible. Luckily, I'll be able to burn a shield right here, but they're definitely gonna get the 2 discharges before Crobat can get to the Shadow Ball. They're currently at 4 Volt Switches. They only need 2 more, all right? They only need 2 more, so I'll definitely have to catch 2 more. I can only fit 2 Air Slash. So what I'm gonna do, 2 Air Slashes, wait 2 turns, switch to Tangrowth, catch the move, and that's the play that will win me the game. Discharge me. I've grown to Crobat. I expect to switch, so don't throw a move. 1 more Air Slash, go for a Shadow Ball, and it's bye to this little spider. It's a great game right there. GG. Alright. Registeel lead. Alright, this is a problem for the team. This is definitely a problem for the team. Alright, yes. The Tin Man. The Tin Trash Can. Don't expect to win these. You can definitely play around them. You know, the awesome part about Registeel, about facing Registeel, is it only has charge move pressure. So if you keep some shields, if you just keep firing resisted moves at it, you will chip it down eventually. It can't sweep your whole team. But if it has something in the back that is kind of good against you, you'll still be kind of in a tough spot. Because it will definitely kill like 1.5 of your Pokemon, all right? But maybe we can get around here. Maybe we can get around. You know, these power whips are really, really adding up already. Only problem is, it's in the red. It's in the red, which is nice, but I can't farm it down. I really can't farm it down. Even Shadow Claws won't farm it down before they get to another Focus Blast. And they do the worst thing ever, and they switch in their Mew right here. This is quite bad for me. Because I gotta stay in here. I really gotta stay in here. Because, especially since they swapped out, they probably have a better Typhlosion answer in the back. And I need this super effective Shadow Claws on the Mew. They go for the Wild Charge as well, which almost knocks me out. Go for the Blast Burn right here. Though, maybe if it's like a Venusaur in the back, I have a shot. But I really doubt it is, right? It's a Jellicent. Which makes this really, really tough. Bubble Jellicent as well, which helps, I think. Especially if they're in Ice Beam. I am usually expecting Ice Beam with Bubble Jellicent. It's either, most of the movesets are either Bubble Beam, or Hex Bubble Beam Shadow Ball, or Bubble Ice Beam Shadow Ball. They actually shield my move though, And at this point, like, they're close to another Ice Beam. So I'm hoping that I can farm down this Registeel, and then Shadow Ball, they're jettisoned. So I go for the Poison Fang on CMP. If I can farm this down now, I'll be fine. Flash Cannon shouldn't do that much, but it brings me to 1 HP. And I die before I can farm him down. And that is, unfortunately, game over right there. All things considered, though, I think we brought it really, really close. My Shadow Crobat also isn't the best IVs, you know. You can go for an XL. This is no XL team. This is non-XL Shadow Crobat. But you can choose to go for an XL variant. And that little bit of extra bulk might have helped me out there. But yeah, it's also very expensive. All right, we had a Sylveon lead, which is actually not bad for Tangrowth. But I have 2 better answers in the back, in Typhlosion and Crobat, which just absolutely shit on Charmers. So I always just switch in my Typhlosion, they bring in Damachamp, this is okay, I'll bring in Crobat, farm it down, get a bunch of energy. Again, Tangrowth also not bad versus Charmers, so I don't really need Switch Advantage. I really don't need Switch Advantage. Unless it's Stunfisk in the back, then I really wish I got Switch Advantage. But against Machamp, you also can't force Switch Advantage with Typhlosion. You bring in Sylveon versus my Poison type. That is weird. That is really, really weird. They must be insanely weak to Crobat then. We've already seen Sylveon. We've already seen Machamp. Is there another Pokemon weak to Crobat in the back? Just shoot this up. There must be. There must be. Shoot this up from them as well. The Psyshock would knock me out. I mean, do they move? Of course. Sinnoh Cavalier. So yes, this team is very weak to Crobat. I barely got to the Shadow Ball here, actually. They actually die, or they have a Drillrun ready right now, because it's 7 counters for Drillrun. And it was, which is 14 turns, and I got to my Shadow Ball at 12 turns, because it took 4 Ash Slashers. So they actually barely, luckily over-farmed there. So otherwise this would have been a problem, because I was definitely in Drillrun range right there. Yeah, we take it out. Poison Fang to Sylveon, and that's a great game. Right there. Triple weak to Crobat. Actual big core breaker right here. All right. Next match. I can't see. Tangrowth is so freaking massive. It is so freaking massive. Like, luckily the name and the typing is on the top right. Otherwise, I wouldn't know what is there. But it is a Scrafty. Oh, now it's a Nidoqueen. It's like a disappearing act, dude. No, he sacrificial swapped. He just sacrificial swapped, which I didn't see because, well, you can't see it, alright? You really just can't see it. That's a downside of bringing Tangrowth. It's just so freaking huge. It's like worse than Wailord. Alright. Even though I resist all the moves, Poison Fang from Nidoqueen is just ridiculous. And I'm already almost in the red. So I've got to throw the Shadow Ball right there. If no shield, this is kind of problematic. But fine. Also, I brought in Crobat versus their Nidoqueen, which is not ideal. Because I would rather have Crobat on Scrafty, but Crobat's also my only Nidoqueen answer. It's not good. They actually power punched me, which I was very surprised about. They power punched me. And I shielded it, which is awful. Which is really, really bad. I could have saved the shield. And I'm just going to let this one. Now, hopefully I can farm this down with Tangrowth. It'd be quite nice. I don't want to risk getting hit by a Foul Play though, and they were barely there. Foul Play would definitely knock me out, so I'm gonna no shield this actually as well, because Typhlosion without shields is also quite bad. I really gotta hope they have something in the back which is weak to Typhlosion now. It's a Stunfisk. Alright. This might be possible, because this thing does get knocked out by a Blast Burn with some Shadow Claw damage. Alright. But it's really close, because they already hit a Rock Slide. They're always going to hit a Rock Slide. That's why I no-shielded that. If I didn't no-shield that, I think they might be able to get to a Rock Slide and then an Earthquake. But since I knew that it was a Rock Slide, I just no-shielded it. Because as you can see, they would have gone into another one. And then they can't Earthquake me anymore. So I definitely survived this matchup. Now, I kill this Stunfisk. But can I farm down the Scrafty now? Come on, come on. Barely can't. One Shadow Claw away. That was a good game. All right, Alola Ninetales lead with Charm. This is way better for me than with Powder Snow. That is for sure. But like normally against Charmers, I would just switch it to Typhlosion. But since I have Rock Slide, I prefer to just throw one of them and then try to catch the Weather Ball on Typhlosion. As you can see, they burnt the shield, which is ideal. They bring in Politoed though, which is not amazing. Since the nerf though, these Weather Balls don't do that much. Like, pre-nerf, I think the Weather Ball, the double Weather Ball right there would have knocked me out. But the Ice Weather Ball plus the Water Weather Ball. But now I get there. Now I get to the beam, which I throw. I'm not really expecting a shield. Guys, they're already shields down. And I have a Tangrowth. But they did shield, which kind of gives away for me that I have Blizzard, right? I don't think they would have shielded that if they didn't have Blizzard. Because they would not be able to get their shield back. Because I would just tank all those Weather Balls. So shield up, shield the Blizzard. Really nice. And I'm just going to let this go. I'm just going to farm up a bunch here. Since I knew they were just throwing a Weather Ball, I didn't really need to risk that. They bring in Mandibuzz. And this is not amazing. Again, Mandibuzz is pretty tricky for this whole team. Because all three of these actually lose. But all three also have play. They're like close matchups. So you can definitely like play around it. I bring Crobat right here. Just to tank the energy. And a couple Air Slashers plus Poison Fang should be able to knock this out. They're currently in the red. I don't think this Poison Fang knocks him out yet though, but one Air Slash after this might. Two actually. And that's beautiful because they die with their move right there. In comes Politoed. It's gonna go for the Fang immediately. They still have a Ninetales in the back, but it's dry on energy. And I think kind of low health. We'll see. I'm not sure. No, I think it's still in the green actually, so not great. They're bringing in right now. It's not low health at all. All right, they were dry on energy. They currently throw 4 charms. It's 6 charms for the Weather Ball. And I'm honestly gonna do something stupid here. I should have just taken the Weather Ball on the Crobat, because these charms are really hurting Crobat. Instead, I decided to catch it on Tangrowth. this was risky, because as you're gonna see, these charms get really close to taking me out. Luckily, I have a Poison Fang stored though, and I kill this Politoed, and it's a great game. I think it's a final game of the video as well. I hope you enjoyed this showcase of the NoXL team once again. If you try it out, it is a really cool team. And if you enjoyed this video, please consider hitting the like, the sub, helps out the channel. And I'll see you in the next one. Good luck with your battles.